Hi, this is Ethan with BIMsmith. Today we will discuss how to use materials downloaded from Market or Forge when they are in a Revit project. First, let's define some terms. A Revit material is a combination of identity data, a graphic representation data, and an appearance asset, at a minimum. It can also contain physical and thermal information for some of Revit's advanced analysis features, but that's a topic for another video. The appearance asset controls how the material will look in realistic mode and when the material is rendered, and can be made in a couple different ways. One option is to use a specialty asset, like metal or paint, and simply assign an RGB color code. Another option is to use an image or images for a custom material. However, to save on file size, those images are not imported into the Revit project. By default, Revit has a large library of textures on your local computer that it will use for the out-of-the-box Revit materials. Occasionally, here at BIMsmith, we will tweak those images to create the look of a manufacturer's material, but most of our materials use custom images created from actual product photography, and these custom images are provided in a download along with a Revit project. When you download a product from Market or Forge that contains custom images, your download is a zip file with a Revit project and all the images you need to make the materials work. However, we often get architects calling who have materials that aren't relinking and appear gray in realistic mode. The best way to make these materials work is to set up a rendering location folder for Revit and copy and paste the images you get into that folder. Rendering locations are folders on your local computer or your network that tells Revit where to look to relink any images. If you're working on your local computer, we suggest creating a folder under Documents called BIMsmith. This is how the BIMsmith plugin works. If you work on a network with other people, you should set up a folder in a common location that everyone can access. This way, when your coworker opens a project and adds materials, your Revit can look in the right place for the custom images. For this to work, you'll need to do the following steps on all your networked computers. To add a rendering location to Revit, go to File, then click Options, then select the Rendering tab on the side. Now, copy and paste the location of the folder that you created in the previous step, and Revit will look there for images. Now, when you download something from Market and Forge, remember to first copy the images to that folder, then open Revit File, and the images will automatically load. Next, let's talk about getting those materials out of the project you've downloaded and into the project that you're working in. When you download an assembly that you've configured from BIMsmith Forge, you can copy and paste it from the Forge project to the job you're working in. To do this, on the sheet, double-click on a view to activate it and select the assembly. Simply copy and paste the wall, floor, ceiling, or roof that you customized in Forge to the job you're working in. Now you can either create a new instance or replace a generic system family. Keep in mind that your system family has the same name that you gave it on BIMsmith Forge. But we know that sometimes you already have the perfect system family, and you just want to update a layer or two with new materials. Let's say you have a brick wall that you've been using forever, but it uses that awful default burgundy brick. You can create a wall on Forge with just one layer. It just contains a brick that you want to use to replace the default Revit brick. Once you've built that wall and downloaded it, you can copy and paste the whole wall into your working project. But if you don't want the system family to clog up your working project, you can transfer just the materials. First, go to the Manage tab in the Receiving project, the one that you want the new brick to end up in, and click on Transfer Project Standards. In the drop-down menu at the top of the dialog box, select the project that you got from BIMsmith Forge. Then uncheck all the options and select Only Materials. Sometimes when you transfer project settings, you'll get a list of materials that you already have in the project that you're trying to transfer them into. You have three options. You can either overwrite the existing materials with the new ones, only transfer new materials, or cancel the whole operation. Once you've transferred the materials, you can go to the system family and edit the wall you've been using with the Revit brick and replace it with the brick material you downloaded from BIMsmith Forge. You could even make a wall on BIMsmith Forge with several different kinds of brick and then download it. Then try each kind of brick to see which option you prefer. Now, sometimes you don't want all the materials, but the Transfer Project Standards tool will always bring all the materials from one project to the next. In this case, a workaround that you can use is to create a generic wall and use the Paint tool to put the material that you want on that wall, and then copy and paste the generic wall into your working project. That'll bring the material with it. If you download a project from BIMsmith Market, there are usually way more images and materials than there are in a Forge project. Most of our BIMsmith Market product libraries have entire product lines from a manufacturer. In these projects, we have created sheets with material swatches for each material offered. Simply activate the view on the sheet, select the material swatch or swatches that you want, and then copy them into your working project. The swatches are Revit families hosting just a material. It's extremely simple and it won't add to your Revit project file size, but we do recommend deleting the family from the project browser when you're done. This has been a starter guide to Revit materials. We hope this helps you with your next project. Thanks for watching.